from the home of former Carter, President Jimmy Carter from Plains, Georgia, Keith Steinmore. And from Ackworth, Georgia, Ranger Ross.
All right, well, fans, we're going to see Ranger Ross and Keith Steinmore here one-on-one here on the Superstation TBS. Indeed, Luger's motivation tomorrow is to retain the United States Heavyweight Championship. I have to wonder, and I'm going to ask Ricky Steamboat this in a few moments right here on the set, what his motivation is, because I think it may be something different than going for the gold, going for the materialistic symbol that the championship belt represents. I'm going to ask him that a little bit later in this program. Ranger Ross riding Keith Steinborn. Ranger, one of the outstanding young gentlemen in this sport, certainly a credit to the profession of pro wrestling, certainly a credit to all the servicemen and former servicemen and women that have served our country so proudly. He is not resting on his laurels as a former medal winner from President Ronald Reagan. He's making his way, he's earning his way right here. Nice drop toe hold, floats up right into the arm bar. Ranger Ross' background speaks for itself, but he is not, as I said, resting on those laurels. He's taking his lumps, he's winning matches, and he's lost a few. But who can't say that? Perhaps other than the great Muta, who is still undefeated in the NWA. That may be changed tomorrow. Is the Stinger the man to finally put the mark on the right side of the column for the great Muta in the one-loss column tomorrow afternoon? Ranger Ross, snap Mary Keith Steinborn over. Tommy Young down for that two count. Back into the arm bar as a Ranger. Don't forget, fans, the Great American Bash continues through August the 6th. And that's when it will end, right here in Atlanta, in the Omni. And I understand that Nature Boy Ric Flair has signed to be on that card. He may not be the champion on August 6th. That's a certainty. He may not be. It remains to be seen. Tomorrow we will find out. Is Flair 100%? The question a lot of people are asking, is he physically 100%? Mentally, no doubt. He is obsessed to take the fight to Terry Funk. Terry Funk is obsessed to take the fight, as we heard earlier, to Nature Boy Ric Flair. It's the irresistible force and the immovable object. And that's going to be happening tomorrow. One, two, and Steinborn kicks out. Don't forget, fans still to come. In the danger zone, Paul E. Dangerously will be speaking with the Stinger, the world television champion, and hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Plus our main event, the Steiner brothers. I noticed Steiner's young friend, Robin Green, is here in her seat that has been reserved for her by Rick Steiner. They'll be taking on Wild Bill Irwin and the Iron Sheik in our main event. Kicked out, showing that he has some tenacity, trying to not quit, competing here with Ranger Ross, who I think we can safely say is on a much higher skill level. Ranger fighting fire with fire there. He knows about infighting. He knows about putting it all on the line. Downstairs he goes with the right hand. Buried deep to the midsection of Keith Steinborn. And a big comeback kick in Steinborn. He's a never, never land. And another victory for the Ranger. Great job. Yeah. The winner of the match, Ranger Ross. Ranger Ross with a victory here on Superstation TBS. The comeback kick. That's going to take him to a lot of victories here in the NWA. Ranger off with a victory. The fans are going to be speaking to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. All right, fans, we're back here on Superstation TBS. I'm awaiting the arrival of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. We heard earlier from the total package Lex Luger. Remember, it's tomorrow. Tomorrow afternoon. Ricky, how you doing? Thanks for coming out. Interesting comment that Lex Luger made moments ago. I'm sure you heard it. He said, Ricky the Steamboat wants the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. I wonder, however, if that is your real motivation. You've been a world champion. You've been the U.S. champion before. Is that your motivation, or is it to teach Lex Luger a lesson?
You know something, Jim Ross? I could probably count on one hand how many times that I'm going to have a match with this type of a guy, with this feeling going through my body. And that is Lex Luger. Tomorrow in Baltimore, the match that you're going to encounter is the kind of match that I'm going to teach you a lesson. You don't jump the dragon. You don't clothesline the dragon. You don't have me down on my backside begging off to you, hit me with a chair, and then get up here and make fun and tell about it and brag upon it, Lex Luger. You know something, Lex? The U.S. Championship is on the line. And if tomorrow in Baltimore I happen to take it, that's the icing on the cake. But the first initiative is to teach you a lesson. To beat you down. To make you suffer. To make people look at you and say, look at Lex Luger. What kind of a man? He's 6 foot five, 270 pounds. The greatest shape of his life. But you're not in the kind of shape that I am in mentally. Mentally, this is the shape I'm talking about to you, Lex Luger. And you know, when it's all said and done, when that black eye is healed, when that bloody nose is healed, when that broken and dislocated jaw is healed, you know when the real pain starts? The real pain when you look in the mirror, just like you started to tell everybody that works 8 to 5, when you look in the mirror and see that that gold is nowhere along your waist, that is when the real pain starts. You are going to be the U.S. champion, a has-been. Eat it.
All right. He is indeed in a mental state that we have not seen him in a long, long time. Fans, we'll be back. The Danger Zone is coming up next.